Isn't it wonderful, wonderful, wonderful? Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? I have seen, yes, I've heard, it's recorded in God's word. Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? Isn't it wonderful, wonderful, wonderful? Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? I have seen, yes, I've heard, it's recorded in God's word. Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? Isn't it wonderful, wonderful, wonderful? Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? I have seen, yes, I've heard, it's recorded in God's word. Isn't Jesus my Lord wonderful? Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus died for all the children of the world. Happy Sabbath, children.
Happy.
Are we all sitting nicely?
Yes.
Lovely. Now, I have a question. Question number one. Do we all go to school?
Yes.
And now tell me, what happens if you were playing and you got hurt? Yes? Aha, you're going to be given first aid. Somebody else?
You get a wound. You cry. Uh-huh.
Okay, now the next question is, when you get a wound and get first aid, who helps with the first aid?
Friend.
Hmm? Or a teacher.
Lovely. And if the wound is so bad, what do you think the school is going to do?
It's gonna be sad.
Yes, the school is gonna be sad. Uh-huh.
And they are going to take you to hospital.
Thank you. And how are they going to take you to the hospital?
With an ambulance.
Lovely. I love that. In an ambulance. And now, tell me, do you know the people who attend to you in an ambulance? What do we call them? What do we call them?
Nurse.
Huh? Nurse, I love that. Uh-huh. Another one?
Doctors.
Doctors. And which one word do we give them, the nurses and the doctors? What do we call them? The ones who are, yes, Michael? They are first aiders. They're
Red Cross.
Red Cross. Lovely. Now we have one big word that we call them. They are called the paramedics. What do you call them? Thank you. Now the next question is, how many of us loved going ushago? Thank you. Now tell me, are the toilets in Ushago the same as the ones here in Nairobi? How do the ones in Ushago look like? Huh?
They are latrines.
They are latrines. And how are latrines?
They look like a hole in the ground.
They look like a hole in the ground. Has anyone ever tried to peep in that hole? Has anyone ever tried? And what? Can you go down to that hole? And now let's imagine if somebody falls in that hole. What's going to happen?
Teacher, you get hurt.
Yes, you'll get hurt. Uh-huh. And now, when you fall in that hole, you're going to get hurt. Now tell me, how are you going to get somebody out of that hole? How?
With the rope.
lovely with a what? A rope. And if the hole is very deep, do you think people will need help? Who do you think they're going to call for help?
Father.
Call the father? Uh-huh.
You will call a strong man to come and pull that person.
Lovely.
And then he'll call a strong man to come there and pull the strong stone.
Lovely.
And you'll call your mother.
Okay, thank you. Now, one more question. And do we know who a journalist is? Who is a journalist? Shout to me, just tell me loudly. A person who reports on news. Lovely. Now, can I have everyone sitting nicely? Everyone sit nicely as we start to listen to our story today. Now, children, I imagine when Jesus was on earth, he loved children very much. And I know even children really loved Jesus. They'll go to Jesus and sit on his laps. And I know one of the days, as he was sitting with them, he must be telling them stories. And I imagine at this time, he must have told them about commandment number 5. And we're going to read from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 1. Please help us with that. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 to 3. Kindly highlight that for us. And let's look, let's read together. Children, obey your parents. For this is right. Yes, thank you. We've heard that, isn't it? Now, once upon a time, there was a little boy who was 7 years old. How many of you are 7 years old? Put up your hand. And Tommy was in the garden playing, and with him was his daddy. Daddy was working in the garden, and Tommy was playing. And all of a sudden, Daddy could not see Tommy. He went everywhere calling, "Tommy, Tommy," but Tommy was nowhere in the garden. Daddy went into the house and called, "Tommy, where are you?" And Daddy and Tommy could not say anything. Daddy could not see Tommy anywhere. And Daddy had only one place to go. And look, outside the garden, there was a very deep hole. So Daddy went and peeped inside and called, "Tommy." And Daddy heard, "Yes, Daddy, I'm in here." And Daddy said, "Okay, Tommy, I'm going to call for help. But in the meantime, please move near to the walls of that deep hole." And Tommy listened and moved to the side. And Daddy went into the house. And whom did he call? Where did he call them?
He called mother.
He called mother? Uh-huh. Now, whom did he call for help? Daddy needed help. Where did he call for help?
Auntie.
I called auntie. But this time, Daddy called the ambulance. And not only the ambulance, Daddy needed more help. He called for the rescue, people who can help in rescuing or helping Tommy out of the hole. And Daddy was there in the house and waiting and walking up and down and wondering, how long is this help gonna come? And he was there waiting and waiting. He heard something. And he listened and listened. Can you all listen together? Can you all listen together? What is that? The ambulance. And the ambulance kept coming and coming. Daddy went outside the gate and showed the ambulance where to go. And when the ambulance got to the house, Daddy stopped it. And now this time, there were two of them. There was the ambulance, and now the other big car or the other truck that was going to help Tommy out of the home. And now things started happening very, very fast. And what did the ambulance, what did the paramedics get out of the ambulance? What did they get out of the ambulance, the paramedics? The what? What did they get out of the ambulance? Yes?
A rope.
A rope, a good try, and somebody else. When the ambulance comes, what do they carry with them to help you rest in the ambulance? A what? Lovely, thank you, Bradley. So they came out with the stretcher and things are happening really fast. Now, the other people came out with something like this. Now, what is this?
A rope.
A rope. And they all ran to where Tommy must have been. Now, they went and said, Daddy had to speak to Tommy and told him, Tommy, our help has come. But now you need to stay there and listen carefully for the instructions. And then they brought the rope, here it is, and the rescue team started lowering this rope down and down into that deep hole. And finally, when Tommy got it, he told Daddy, Daddy, I got it. Now he had to listen for the instructions. He was told, Tommy, now with that rope, it has a loop in it. Now you are going to have that loop and you need to wear it like you wear your t-shirt. So what goes in first? Your hands. So hands first, and it was told all the way down to your laps. And then the next thing you need to do is pretend that you are sitting. So pretend that he was sitting. And then the next thing is, you need to hug the rope like you're hugging Daddy. So he did that. And now finally, after he had done that, now he said, Daddy, I've done it. So now the rope had to come up. And the rescue guys had to help to pull this rope. Now this rope was no one pulling it, but there was a big car that was helping to pull this rope. So the rope came up and up. And can you hear it? Can you hear it? Up and up and up and up and up and up and until Tommy was out. And everybody was happy. Even the journalists had come. When they said Tommy, they all clapped and said, Tommy, Tommy. And everyone was so excited to see him. But now Tommy had a problem. He couldn't walk because he had really hurt his legs. He just couldn't stand. So the paramedics took him quickly into the stretcher and right in the ambulance. And now when everyone was looking there, the journalist had to walk to Daddy and ask him, we are very surprised at your 7-year-old son, at the way he can follow instructions. And you know what Daddy said? He said, Tommy is a very obedient boy. He follows instructions to the best of his understanding. And children, that's our question today. Can your mommy and daddy say that you are very obedient? Can they say that you follow instructions to the best of your understanding? Can they say that? Remember, children, once we obey our parents, we are obeying God Himself. If you don't obey your parents, you are disobeying God Himself. And remember, if Tommy had not learned to obey, he would have not obeyed in the hole. And what would have happened to him? What would have happened to him if he didn't follow any instructions in the hole? What would have happened to him? What would have happened? He would have? Yes?
He would have stayed in the hole.
And then what happens to him when he stays in the hole? He?
Died.
Thank you. He dies. Remember, if he had not listened to the instructions very well, he would have died. And that is where Jesus tells us that if we obey our parents, we get to live more days. Like Tommy was able to live for more days because he learned and he always obeyed. And that's the end of our story.